Hi, today I'm going to show you how to knit this girly pleated dog sweater. Let's get started. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to knit pleats, also how to put them together. So if you wanna know how to knit the air dog sweater, please watch my other video. I will put the links in my description box. Okay? I already knit most of the dog sweater. Neck, that part, and increasing around the chest area, then leg hole, okay, and tummy area. So I haven't done the rib part because I want to put the pleats instead of the just a regular rib, okay. And also, I have to mention one more thing is that I am going to knit pleats separately. Then I'm gonna attach the pleats onto the sweater. So the number of the stitches has to be matched. But the tricky part is because you're making pleats, which is kind of folding, you will lose half of the stitches. So first of all, you have to count how many stitches you need from the sweater. Okay? That is why you have to make a plan way ahead. Okay? And the stitch number has to be multiple of 10 plus 2. So I decide I'm gonna use 82 stitches from the sweater. Okay? And again, this pleats technique, you ended up lose half of the stitches. So as I told you before, I need 80 stitches total later, so you have to double the number. So 80 times 2 plus 2 is 162, which is still multiple of 10 plus 2. Okay, so you need cast 162. First of all, don't worry about the markers. I just didn't want to count so many times, so I just put the marker. And I'm just making sure the which side I'm on. Okay. I'm actually facing to wrong side. So if it's starting on wrong side, you need to do the preparation row, which is start with purl 4, start with purl 4, and with some bracket you have to repeat. Okay, so after purl 4 you have to repeat knit 4 and purl 6. So you have to do knit 4, purl 6 until last 8 stitches. Okay, just knit 4 purl 4, purl 6 until last 8 stitches. And again, if you don't understand that ended up you will lose half of the stitches at the very end, please watch this video until the end. Then you figure it out. Okay? And this is end of the preparation row. If you are starting with the right side, you can skip this preparation row. Okay? And if you knit until last 8 stitch, then you will knit 4 and purl 4. That's the end of the preparation row. Okay, that's gonna be last 8. And this the pleats technique, it's good for the regular skirt, you know, for kids skirt, you know, or some, you know, sleeves for sweater. It's really cute. Okay, so it's good to learn. And now row number 1, I'm facing to right side. It's easy. Knit 4 to start, then Whitson bracket is repeating, which is purl 4 and knit 6 until last 8 stitch, then purl 4 and knit 4. But you know what, this is pretty much knit over knit stitch and purl over purl stitch. So if you did the preparation row, it's easy. And if you start with the row number 1, you cannot make mistake on the first row. Okay? This is end of row number 1. Again, purl 4 and knit 4. Okay? And row number 2 will be coming up, which is wrong side. Is same as preparation row. Again, it's purl up over purl stitch and knit over knit stitch, but I just want to make sure, you know, row number 2 wrong side is purl 4 to start, then you have to repeat Whitson bracket, knit 4 and purl 6 until last 8 stitch, then last 8 stitch will be knit 4 and purl 4. And you have to repeat row number 1 and row number 2 as many as you want, you know, but you have to finish with row number 2. Okay? And I did total of 4 times repeat row number 1 and row number 2. And this is the length I like. So again, I made the total of four times repeating row number one and row number two. If you want to have a longer pleat, you can actually keep doing, but make sure you have to finish with row number two. So now, let's start row number three. Okay? And you need cable needle this time. Row number three, right side. Okay? Knit two first. This is a little bit complicated, so you have to watch first. Okay? And next two stitches, you have to pick up two stitches with cable needle. CN means cable needle. Okay? Then next four should be purl four. Okay? You will pick up those four stitch with right needle. RN means right needle. Okay? Four stitches. Then with cable needle, you have to pick another two stitches. Okay? So now four on the cable needle. Okay? Then earlier you picked four stitches with right needle. Those four you will transfer back onto left needle. Just like that. Okay? Then four on the cable and those four on the left needle. Now you knit two together. This is the reason why you lose some of the stitches. Okay? You put the right needle into cable stitch, then left stitch, then knit two together. Okay? And take stitches off from the both needle, which is the left needle and cable needle. This is the first one. And three more. Cable needle stitch and left needle stitch. Then knit two together. I'm having a little bit struggle, but take your time, please. Okay? And third stitch from cable needle, then left as well. I'm trying to kind of knit one by one. I'm just thinking which way is easier for me to knit. Now, last stitch from cable needle and left needle. Knit it together and take both stitches off. Okay, there you go. Done. Then you will start from the beginning again. Okay? So from beginning, knit two, right? Then with cable needle, pick up two stitches and leave the cable out front, okay? Then pick four stitches, which is actually purl four. Then pick up another two stitches with cable needle. Then four stitches from right to left, transfer back. Then tricky part, knit those four stitches two together. Okay, so one from needle, the cable needle and left needle, then knit two together there. So again, you have to repeat from the beginning until this, you know, knit two together thing. Okay, so knit two, pick up two stitches from the cable needle, then pick up four stitches from the left needle to right needle, and use the cable needle again, pick up another two. So four stitches on the cable needle, right? Then four on the right needle, transfer back onto the left needle, then knit two together. And you have to repeat until last two stitches left. Okay? If you're not making any mistake, it has to be two stitches at the end, then knit two. So I'm actually doing last tricky part. I just pick the two stitches with the cable needle and pick four stitches from left to right, and two stitches picking up with cable needle, then transfer those four stitches back from right to left, then thumb part, knit two together. One from cable and two from the left needle. Knit two together. Last, knit two together. Then there you go. There's two stitches left. Then you just knit two. Okay? And this is not the end yet. Row number four, wrong side. Straight forward. Knit three and knit two together. Then you have to repeat with some bracket, which is knit four and knit two together until last three stitch. Then knit three at the end. As you already know, in row number three, you lost four stitches every time you use the cable needle. Right? And now you lose one stitch every time you do knit two together. So this is the reason why you lose half of the stitches at the end. Okay? Again, this is the end of row 4. You just keep doing knit 4 and knit 2 together until last 3 stitch left. Then knit 3 at the end. Then row number 5, all knit. You have to finish with right side. Okay, because now you have to attach onto the sweater right side together, and I would like to start with wrong side. So, there we go. Look at that. It's nice looking pleat. Okay, so now you want to attach onto the sweater. Okay. Please make sure the stitch count matches, okay? And now you have to cast off the front part, okay? That part I have to cast off, and then now you have to count and make sure, you know, number is match, and if so, you just knit around until the marker, then cast off in between those markers, because this is for the dog, and you know, even though the girl dog has to, you know, pee, so I kind of want to have open space on the, you know, tummy area. So I would like to have a little bit of opening there. So I made, I think, 9 cast off to matches the stitches with the pleats part. Okay. Okay, sometimes, you know, people think, I don't like putting, you know, the pleats part onto the sweater because it's kind of pain in neck. You know, I like seamless, but because the this pleat technique, you have to start from bottom to top. So only this is the way you have to do it. Okay? So now you will attach the pleats onto the sweater then, okay? And it has to be right side together, okay? Right side together, which means I'm facing to wrong side of the pleat part. Then knit 2 together, same as, you know, the cable needle one, okay? Knit 2 together, and you have to make 2, then cast off at the same time. Okay, so you made 2 stitch there, then cast off there. Okay, so you just keep doing cast off, but you know, there's 2 on your left hand side. That's it. That's the only difference. Okay, and again, I just want to make sure where to start. Is you cast off in front of the tummy area, right? So right after the cast off, you have to start, because again, 82 stitches on the sweater and pleat parts, right? So you have to start, you know, right after the cast off. Okay? Again, in this video, I didn't show you how to knit whole dog sweater. I just showed you how to knit the pleat and how to put them on to the dog sweater. So if you want to know how to knit dog sweater, please watch my other video. I put the link in the description box. Okay? Enjoy knitting! Bye for now!